God, we are back again. We serve an amazing God. Hello, I am Apostle Johnny McDonald, along with the Spring Valley Baptist Church family right here in the city of Gainesville, Alabama. God have yet entrusted me with another series entitled, Let's Take the City. I believe that God has equipped our minds to be city takers in this season. And I don't know about you, but if you want to go with us and be city takers, we want to invite you because we're getting ready to go to worship and God have given us a powerful word entitled Ambush. So come go with us. For those of you who cannot go, we will see you after this. about the Lord this morning?
Dismayed. Take all the people of war with thee. Arise, go up to Ai, shout Ai.
Ai.
See, I have given into thy hand the king of Ai, his people, his city, his land. And thou shalt do to Ai and her king as thou didst to Jericho and her king. All the spoils thereof, the cattle thereof, ye shall take. For a prey unto yourselves, lay thee an ambush, shout ambush.
Ambush
for the city behind it.
All right.
So Joshua arose and all the people of war to go up against Ai. And Joshua chose out of 30,000 mighty men of valor and sent them away by night. Let's pick up in verse 9. Joshua therefore sent them forth, and when they went to lie in ambush, shout ambush.
Ambush.
And abode between Bethel and Ai, on the west side of Ai. But Joshua lodged that night among the people.
All right.
Joshua rose up early in the morning and numbered the people and went up, he and the elders of Israel, before the people to Ai.
All right.
And all the people, even when the people of war that were with him went up, drew nigh and came before the city and pitched on the north side of Ai. Now there was a valley between them and Ai. And he took about 5,000 men and sent them to lie in ambush between Bethel and Ai on the west side of the city.
Amen.
When they had sent the people, even all the host that was on the north side of the city, their liars in wait on the west side of the city of Joshua, went that night into the midst of the valley. And it came to pass when the king of Ai saw it, they hastened and rose up early, and the men of the the city went out against Israel to battle. And he and all his people at that appointed time before the plan. But he wist not that there was liars in ambush. Shall ambush?
Ambush.
Against him behind him in the city. And Joshua and all Israel made as if it were beaten before them and fled by the way of the wilderness. And all the people that were in Ai called together to pursue after them. They pursued after Joshua and came and drew and were drawn away from the city. There was not a man left in Ai Bethel. He went not out after Israel and left the city open and pursued after Israel. And the Lord said unto Joshua, stretch out thy spear that is in thy hand towards Ai, for I will give it into thy hand. Joshua stretched out his spear, and he had taken his hand towards the city. And the ambush, shout ambush,
ambush,
arose quickly out of their place and ran as soon as they had stretched out of his hand, and they entered into the city and took it in haste and set the city on fire. Quickly put your Bible out there, you do. Your cell phones down, open your mouth, put your hands together, give the Lord a hand. We've been working the last couple of weeks with this short series entitled Let's Take the City.
Amen.
And we want to continue to build this morning upon that same topic, Let's Take the City, Part 3.
All right.
But I want to add a subtopic to this text entitled Ambush.
All right.
I need you to shout that three times.
Ambush.
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 Ambush. For the next 30 to 45 minutes, that's what we want to talk about. Ambush the city. Ambush is an English word that is actually taken from a Hebrew word called arab. The word arab in the Hebrew simply means to lie in wait in a concealed place, waiting for a sudden attack.
All right.
An ambush, for as scriptures are concerned, is always connected to the phrase lie in wait.
All right.
An ambush is an appear to be an emotionless position while only moving at a certain pace where the enemy doesn't even recognize that you're moving.
Amen.
Ambush is positioning yourselves in a motionless position. But because you're moving so slow and smooth, the enemy don't even recognize that you're moving. Lying in wait does not mean to be lazy, slothful, inactive, or inattentive. Lying in wait means that you're preparing to get within striking distance of the enemy. When studying the Bible, you'll find out that there are several occasions where Israel was involved in an ambush. You find in 2 Chronicles 13, Jeroboam had set up an ambush against Judah, but Judah praised her way out of it. You also find in the book of Jeremiah 51, that God told Israel to set up an ambush against the nation of Babylon.
Amen.
Yeah, so that they could take over the city.
Amen.
Here in the text of Joshua chapter 8, God, out of all of the military strategies, he decided to use what is known as ambush. Shout ambush.
Ambush.
God here chooses this strategy because it is slightly different from the strategy that he used in chapter 6.
All right.
Here in this ambush attack, it is totally different from the attack they used in chapter 6.
All right.
Chapter 6, they did something that we discovered that made no sense at all.
Okay.
But when you are obedient to the word of God,
yes,
and the voice of God,
all right,
success always comes from those who are obedient.
Amen.
Whether it makes sense or not, success always follow obedience.
Yes.
So in chapter 6, we understand that God had given the city to Joshua.
Amen.
The city of Jericho. In chapter 7, we find that Joshua decided to go to Ai himself.
Amen.
And he found himself being defeated by the Ai.
Yeah.
But here in chapter 8, God comes back and God gives him the go-ahead to go back and take the city of Ai.
Amen.
When I begin to look at this text, there are about six things that I want to go through quickly with you to show you how that we can be successful as a body of believers in an ambush attack to take a city. The first thing that I want to identify here in this text is the instructions that God gave them in chapter 8 is totally different from those in chapter 6. In chapter 6, God told them to walk around the city. In chapter 8, God told them to lay down behind the city. In chapter 6, God told them to shout and to blow. But in chapter 8, he tells them to be quiet. In chapter 6, they could not keep none of the accursed thing for themselves.
Amen.
But here in chapter 8, he told them to keep all the spoils,
yes,
and the cattle for their prey.
Yeah.
Now, I wonder why did God not let them keep nothing in chapter 6?
All right.
But he told them to keep everything in chapter 8. And the reason why God did that is because the attack in chapter 6 was different from the attack in chapter 8.
Yeah.
In chapter 8, they was given instructions to walk around, to blow and shout. It was more of a praise fight. But here in chapter 8, he told them to ambush.
Yes.
And the difference is that anytime that you ambush something and you are successful, you automatically comes out with the praise.
Go ahead.
Y'all missed that. Y'all missed that. So anytime that an animal ambushes its prey, if it is successful, then it comes out with its prey.
Yeah.
If it is unsuccessful, then the prey gets away.
Amen.
So if Israel would have went down at an ambush and attacked Ai and would have come out with nothing, it would have been a sign that they was unsuccessful. But because it was an ambush, God allowed them to bring out the spoils and all of the cattle. And I just want to prophesy to somebody to let you know that this city that you're about to take, the last time you went down, you didn't bring out nothing. But this time, shout this time, I'm bringing out everything. You bringing out everything because the attack is different. In chapter 6, it was a praise. And in chapter 8, it is a worship. Now notice that he tells them to walk and to shout and to blow in chapter 6. But in chapter 8, he tells them to lay. Now how can you understand that laying down is a signal or a sign of prostrate? It is a position that you get in to worship God. So he said, lie down in chapter 8. And bring out the spoils of the city. And in chapter 6, God says, watch this. He said, I have given you the Jericho. I have given you the king and the mighty men of Valor. In chapter 6, he gave them three things. But in chapter 8, he says, I'm giving you the king, shout king. His people, shout his people.
His city,
and his land. in chapter 6, they come out with three things. In chapter 8, they come out with four. The land actually represents what is known as colonies that is established by the king.
All
right. Even though the land is not a part of the city at this time,
yeah,
it is still a part of the king's territory.
Wait,
so last time, you didn't get no extra property. But this time,
yes,
God said you're coming out with the land.
Yeah.
Last time, you just killed the king.
Yeah.
The people of war,
yeah,
and took the city.
Yeah.
But the Lord said, this time, you're coming out with the king,
yeah,
the people, the city,
yeah,
and the land.
Yeah.
Somebody here shout the land.
So
now we look at number one, the instructions were totally different.
All right.
And when we look at number two, we find out that in number two, there was an arrangement or an order that was made.
Yeah.
And in chapter 9, beginning in chapter 9 through verse 9 up to verse 13, there's an arrangement of order. You just can't do an ambush no any kind of way. You got to have order to do an ambush.
Yeah.
I know we used to get doing stuff any kind of way,
right,
any kind of way we feel like it, any kind of way we think it ought to be, but there's an order. Shout order.
Right.
That an ambush has to be done.
Yeah.
Now in verse 9, the Bible said, Joshua sent the men forth. He told them to lie in ambush. Watch this. He says that when you lie in ambush, you lie between Bethel and Ai.
Yeah.
Anybody remember last week? Bethel and Ai is where Abraham stopped and worshiped there.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a certain place you got to be at in order to lay the ambush.
Yeah.
But the most important thing is that Isaac came and stopped between Bethel and Ai.
Yeah.
And then Jacob came and bought the land.
Yeah.
So he said, stop between Bethel and Ai. But then the text says that, and Joshua, verse 10, rose up that morning, and he numbered the people. The word numbered means he put the people in marching order.
Yes.
So even though they was going to lie down behind the city, they was in marching order.
Yes.
So here's the interesting thing about it is that he says that lay down behind the city, get in numbers. He numbered them, put them in order. And the Bible says that when all the people of war were with him, they went up and came before the city, and they pitched on the north side. But when you go back, the important thing is that he says to the people who are going to lie away, he says, you lie on the west side.
Amen.
I'm going to take a group with me, and we're going on the north side.
Yeah.
Now, I don't know about you, but when I look at a city, the west side is always a bad side. Every city you go in, the west side is just rough.
Amen.
But God says that the people who are going to do the ambush got to go to the west side.
Yeah.
Now watch this, because when you're in Bethel, Bethel is somewhat of right here.
Yeah.
Ai is right there.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, Ai is right there. But Bethel is there. Ai is here. And then you find Jericho here.
Yeah.
So if I leave Jericho going to Ai, I have to go either through Ai or go around Ai to get behind it. So now the Lord says go to the west side of Ai.
Amen.
Which means that they got to go to the rough side.
Yeah.
They got to go to the side that they have to conquer this place,
yeah,
and take this city.
Amen.
And I know most of y'all saying, Pastor, you can say if you want, but I ain't going to the west side.
Yeah.
See, only the means of war go to the west side.
Yeah.
And that's what the text said. Get the means of war, and he says that I want you to send them to the west side.
Yeah.
Watch this. The Bible says right there in verse 13, verse 12, he took about 5,000 men. Now this messed me up because he got 30,000 men that God told him to get. But Joshua going to take 25,000 with him, and he's going to send 5,000 to the west side. Look like he'll send 25 to the west side,
yeah,
and took 5 with him.
All right.
So what God is saying is, in order for us to ambush the place, there are going to be more people that's going to be with the leader than there is going to be lying in wait. Because everybody don't have the heart,
yeah,
to lie in ambush.
Yeah.
See, once you get in ambush, you can't get up,
yeah,
and change your mind.
Yeah.
You got to have a heart. So you got to have a heart.
Yeah.
Lay in ambush.
Yeah.
So he said right there in verse 9, he said, the west side of the city. Then in verse 13, he says, he set the people and even all the hosts on the north side and lying wait. And then verse 13, he said, when it came to pass, the king of Ai had rose up the men of the city, they began to go after the 25,000. So number three, the 25,000 represented a decoy. Anytime that you're going to do an ambush, you got to have a decoy.
Go ahead, man.
Now it's different when you're working by yourself.
Go ahead, man.
Because when an animal works by itself, it has to just remain still until the enemy or the prey get close enough so it can attack. Every now and then it can move at a slow pace.
Yeah.
But it has to be patient. It can't move too fast.
Yes.
But when you got a decoy, see, I need about 25 of y'all that don't want to be on the decoy team.
Yeah.
Because even though the ambush team is important, the decoy team is also important.
Yeah.
Because notice the decoy team ain't going around the city. They going straight down the middle.
Yeah.
The Bible says that he took the 25,000 and he set up a decoy and he goes down the middle of the city.
Yeah.
And then once he gets to the middle of the city, he turns around and the 25,000 run.
Go ahead, pal.
Just because you're running in a decoy does not mean that you're staying.
Yeah.
Your assignment here is to set the enemy up.
Yeah.
I'm not talking about the church folk running before you get to the front door.
Yeah.
But I'm talking about those of you who get with the 25 and go all the way to the enemy's front door.
Yeah.
Right. The reason why I'm going to his front door, because there's something in the enemy camp that belongs to me.
Right.
And I made my mind up that this day, God has given me the city.
Yeah.
That this day, God has given me the king.
Yeah.
That this day, God has given me the people.
Yeah.
That this day, God has given me the land.
Yeah.
And the only thing I need
is
some people that are set up an ambush.
Yeah.
You're not afraid,
but
you're set up an ambush.
Yeah.
So number three, that must be a decoy man.
Amen.
Number four, you have to understand that's going to be a pursuit.
Yeah.
While you're running, the enemy is going to be running behind you.
Go ahead, man.
So there's no need of freaking out, getting scared, go singing the old song, the enemy is on my track.
Yeah.
I'm trying so hard to turn him back.
Yeah.
But I don't want him to go back now.
Yeah.
Because I have an ambush set up.
Yeah.
My assignment is to lead him out. But most of us, we'll break down and start singing the old Zion song.
Yeah.
The enemy's on my track, and I'm trying to turn him back.
Yeah.
Baby, I don't want him to go back this time, because I got an ambush set up.
Yeah.
I got some people on my side that's lying in wait.
Yeah.
They waiting on me to bring the enemy that way.
Go ahead.
So here it is, pursuit. The Bible tells us that I believe it was verse 16 and 17 that there was a pursuit. How the enemy, once they take off, the enemy comes after them, and now he pursued them. And the Bible says in verse 17, there was not left a man in the city. I want to draw every spirit out of that place, every demonic force out of that place. I want it to come out. But I need some people who will be a decoy and help me bring him out. I can't bring them out by myself. I need somebody to help me bring him out. I need somebody who's faithful. Who's not going to show up one day but not going to be there the next day. I need somebody who will roll up their sleeves and say, I'm with you.
Yeah.
We're going down together.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, you may be battling something on your job.
Yeah.
I want to be one of those who go on the job with you and help take the city.
Go ahead.
Maybe you're battling something at home. I want to be one of those who go and be a decoy and help take the city.
All right.
Maybe you're battling something that's cool.
Yeah.
I want to be one of those who be a decoy and help you take the city.
Yeah.
Maybe you're battling something between your house and your workforce in the spirit realm.
Yeah,
I want to be a decoy.
Well,
yes, help you take the city.
Yes,
because you have to draw the enemy out.
Right.
The Bible said there's not one left in the city.
Yeah.
Draw every one of them out of the city. So again, number one, that was the instruction.
Yeah.
Number two, that was arrangement.
Yeah.
Then number three, that was the decoy.
Yeah.
Then number four, that was the pursuit. And so now we come to number five, which is the season of the city.
Yeah.
Now right there in verse 18, the Bible says that after there was none left in the city, That's when those who are lying in wait, those who went on the west side, those who were waiting on the sign, those are the ones that when the city is clean, notice that at this point they ain't fighting no man. They waiting on the city to become clean. And at this point, they ain't trying to kill nobody. They just trying to get the city clean. So while you fighting one another and trying to fight people, God said, get the city clean. Clear out the atmosphere. Because if you clear out the atmosphere, the people who are lying in wait can go in and take the city. So here it is. Here it is. Verse 18 says, he said to Joshua, stretch out the spear that is in your hand toward Ai. I will give into thy hand. And he said, Joshua stretched out his spear that he had in his hand. Watch this. Verse 19. The Bible says that the ambush team got up real strong. The Bible says, let me try this out. The ambush team got up in slow motion. The ambush team, some of them leg was hurt. The text says the ambush team got up quickly. Because they knew they had an assignment. They didn't make up excuses about what they got to do before they go into the city. Their mindsets was ready. Their thought process was ready. Only thing they wanted to see was them draw the people out of the city. When spirits begin to come out of the city, it's time for you to get up quickly. The Bible says that they seized the city. They ran as soon as he stretched out his hand. They didn't go in saying what we ought to do. They didn't go in saying what I think we should do. But the Bible said they went in and took the city. They went in and took the atmosphere. In this case, they went in and took a physical city. But with us, we go in and we take the atmosphere. We denounce and call down every prince of the air. Every stronghold. Every power of darkness. Every demonic force. Go in and take the city. And everything that the devil has taken from you. Go in and come out with your joy. Go in and come out with your peace. Go in and come out with your confidence. Go in and come out with your style. Go in and come out with your ability to do something in God. Bible says that he says, once you go in, because of the type of attack you are doing, you shall come out with the sword.
All right.
And the cap.
Go ahead, pal.
But the only way you can get this is you have to go in with the ambush style.
Amen.
So now we come to number six. Number six is the results. Because I went in on an ambush style. I laid wait on the west side of the city. I got in the rough place. The place that some of us don't want to be caught up in. Because it is rough on the west side of the spirit. We want somebody else to go to the west side. But I am an ambusher. Send me to the west side. The Bible said that in verse 23, and King Ai, they took a lie. You remember in chapter 6, they were to bring nobody out alive. But here they bring out the king and they bring him out alive. Because there is a statement that has to be made. The result is that Joshua even took the city of Ai. And the Bible says that when everybody had fallen by the edge of the sword, the scripture says that the Israelites, they returned and came out of Ai, smote everybody that was left with the edge of the sword. Once you take the city, it's time then to kill some demons, to kill some spirits, to kill some strongholds. They begin to kill everything that was in the city alive. The Bible said that Joshua did not withdraw his hand until that everything in the city was destroyed. And the text says only the cattle and the spoil out of that city Israel took the far of prey. I don't know about you, but I'm glad that God gave me a weapon called an ambush. Because anytime that I go in an ambush, I'm looking to come out with all of my stuff. In other words, I'm going in and I'm coming out with a prayer. Is there anybody in the house this morning that want to go in, but you want to come out with a prayer? And God, all right, but what I love about Joshua is the Bible said that he followed the commandments of God. Not only did he come out with a prayer, but the Bible said that Joshua burned the city. I need somebody in the house that don't mind setting the city on fire. Well, Pastor, what kind of fire is it going to set the city on fire with? You ought to set it on fire with the Holy Ghost and with fire. Ain't God all right? But then the Bible says that the end results after Joshua city on fire. The Bible said that Joshua built an altar. Right there in verse 30, it said he built an altar and began to worship God. And God alright, the Bible said he built an altar in the same place that Abraham built. He built an altar in the same place that Isaac built. He built an altar in the same ground that Jacob bought. Is there anybody here that wanna learn how to fight through an ambush? But after the ambush is over, you brought back all of your stuff. Not only have you brought back your stuff, but now you can worship God. I didn't come to church lately, but now I can worship Him. That I came to church the last time, but now I can worship Him. Because last time I didn't have my joy. Now I got my joy. Last time I didn't have my peace. But now I got my peace. Is there anybody here that got the joy back? Is there anybody here that got the peace back?
Go ahead,
pal. Part of the prayer, but this stuff that they brought back.
All right.
People of God, we're in a season.
Yeah.
Where God want to take the body of Christ.
Amen.
And put us in a place where we're taking the city.
Amen.
Because one thing that I discovered, when you take the city in the spirit,
yes,
you automatically take it in the natural.
Amen.
But when you got church people that's not happy,
all right,
not with the joy of God, not with the peace of God, they're struggling with finances, they're struggling with things, issues, stress.
Yeah.
But they're struggling with all of these things.
Yes, Lord.
The people of God cannot worship you.
Amen.
Cannot worship you.
All right.
Yeah, you can come to church, but in order to worship him, you have to release this stuff.
Go ahead, sir.
Amen. But this is what I discovered. An ambush attack always, never forget this, allow you to bring out what you've lost.
All right.
Always.
Amen.
Always.
Always. Thank you, Lord.
So what God is saying that in a person who agrees on a corporate level to go into an ambush attack and begin to take the city, God says there are things he's going to give back to you. Well, watch this, watch this. This is my last thing. This is my last thing. In praise, in chapter 6, it was a praise fight of war in the spirit.
Yeah.
Praise is thanking God, watch this, for what God has given us.
Amen.
So in chapter 6, they couldn't take nothing. Because they had to give thanks to him for what God had already given them.
Yeah,
all right.
Yeah.
In chapter 8, it was about worship.
Yeah.
Worship is taking back what the enemy had taken from you.
Yeah.
But watch this, because worship is giving glory to God for who he is.
Amen.
So anytime you go into worship, you're going into a spiritual thing with God.
Yeah.
Give the power, the authority, and the ability to take back.
All right.
But praise, you just thanking him.
Thank
you. You can't get nothing back.
All right.
So though, this is why he set up around the wall attack.
Yeah.
Chapter 6.
That's right.
But in chapter 8, he set up an ambush attack.
Right. Yeah.
So it all goes together.
Yeah.
From praise to worship. Thanksgiving don't touch nothing. To worship, take it back.
Yeah.
Bring it out. Yeah. Bring it out. Bring it out. Bring it out. Come on, give the Lord a shout of praise. We're going to take this moment to quickly just do a invite those that don't know the Lord Jesus Christ. Maybe you've never accepted him as Savior. We want to give you this opportunity to come and give your life to Christ.
Amen.
Maybe the enemy have ambushed you.
All right.
And have you in a place where you just confused over what to do. But invite you to come.
All right.
Or maybe you're just out there. You're out there and you're struggling, trying to find your way, trying to find your place. And you need a covering. You need a covering. You need a ministry, a church,
yes,
to be over you, to cover you, so you can get what you need to press through life.
Saints of God, we are back. Whew. Did God show up? The Spirit of God fell so heavy. Revelation, illumination on that word entitled Ambush the City. So I want to let you know that whatever you're going through, that we have a city that we have to take, whether it's a city in the spirit realm or whether it's a city in the natural realm. We have the power to take that city. So I hope that you are blessed from this word. I pray that this word will get you to another level in life. And I promise you, if you receive it, your life will never ever be the same again. Saints of God, we have to go now. But I do want you to know that our motto is that some people can cross the bridge themselves, but there's others who need our help. Be blessed, and we'll see you next time.